My name's Rolf Kent, and I wrote the score to the movie Rain Over Me. I've been scoring films for about 18 years, and they include all of Alexander Payne's films, including Election and Sideways. And I also have scored numerous films for Mark Waters, and he directed Mean Girls and Freaky Friday and Just Like Heaven and The House of Yes. And I also do most of Richard Shepard's films, and he made The Matador. And later this year, I'll be doing his film set in Bosnia. Rain Over Me was a real joy for me to score. It was a heartfelt, compassionate, sad drama, and that really drew me to it. And also just watching it, it was a beautiful film. I mean, it had some really touching moments, some incredible performances from Adam Sandler and Don Cheadle. It was also an experiment for me because I'm so married to this idea of writing themes, memorable themes, and I kind of approached it with the idea of writing anti-themes, melodies which did not immediately hook into you, but after you heard them a few times, you gradually get familiar with it. And so it was as if the melodic stuff, you know, I gave it room to have a little more sophistication than sometimes we put into movie music. The main challenge I had to go over for myself on this film was that there wasn't going to be an orchestra, and yet wanting ambient qualities and long stretched out pads of sound. And that was kind of solved two ways. One is I found some simple sounds which had breath and air in them, which worked very well. And the other was that I used ukulele, no, actually not ukulele, I used this instrument. It's a charango. It's this sort of sound. I used that a lot in the film. There was one interesting thing when I did a little gentle humming on one cue. And I liked my humming, but the director thought it should be a female voice. And so I simply wrote out the part, wrote out the notation, got a singer to come in, and she sang part without hearing what I'd sung at all, and it sounded good, but it sounded light, too light, I think. And so I simply pushed the fader up with my voice on it at the same time, and we were, you know, it was really surprising. We were absolutely perfect together, and it meant that in this particular cue, which is this funeral sequence of the film, the two voices, while not ever hearing each other and not, you know, deliberately singing together, but were perfectly meshed. So that's what ended up in the movie, these two voices an octave apart, just perfectly singing together in amongst all the other sounds and qualities of the score. Very simple score with just gentle piano and ambient sounds and some voices sometimes moving in and out of it. Became the way of the way to do it, and it became very natural and very fluid. I found it a moving film, and I found it sort of balm to my soul. It was lovely to work on, and great to work with the director. Mike responded to my music very readily.